The second generation Audi TT is definitely a very stylish and a sporty car. It was made from 2006 to 2014. The design of the interior and the quality of the used materials is fantastic. However, lots of the owners complained about stretched leather on the seats, which is, as you can see, not very nice. The interior build quality is overall, let's say, good, but again, some of the owners complained about rattling noises from the dashboard area or from the rear of the car. The quality of the paint job is quite good, but check it properly before buying anyway. The rust protection is on a very high level, so there shouldn't be rust on the body panels. Also, the front and the middle section of this car are made from aluminium for the better weight distribution. There can be more of a problem with the window regulators, tail lights, and the door handles can stuck. If the car is equipped with the optional Bose sound system, then check if all speakers are working properly, because these speakers and also the amplifier can break quite easily. The convertible version of this car can have also problems with the roof. You can choose from three types of suspension. The standard suspension of this Audi TT is good and it's not that expensive to replace. Then there is the S-Line Sport suspension, which is, guess what? More sportier, stiffer and more uncomfortable, but it's also not that expensive. The last and technologically the most advanced is the optional adaptive magnetic ride suspension, which is standard on the TTS and TTRS models. It automatically adapts to the current situation and you can also switch from normal to sport mode. So, it can be really stiff and, you know, dynamic, but on the other side it can be also a little bit more comfortable than the standard suspension. However, these shock absorbers are, of course, more expensive to replace than the regular ones. The standard equipment of this TT included automatic air conditioning, radio or headlights. No, I mean for real, you get headlights and even rear lights. As you can see, this really is mentioned in the original equipment list. And I am really curious, are there countries where these lights are the part of the optional equipment or something? Well, everything is possible. But let's move on to the optional equipment, which included various leather color combinations, navigation system, cruise control, parking sensors, heated seats, and that Bose sound system, which can break, right? The facelifted version of this TT was made from 2010, and it included some really small, mainly exterior upgrades. The price for this little sports car starts at €7,200 for the cheapest one in Germany and it goes up until €55,990 for a TTRS model. Now, you know the price for this car, but let's check out a high mileage example too. So, as you can see, this is a 2006 model with a 2-liter TFSI 4-cylinder engine. It has a little bit more than 300,000 kilometers and as you probably noticed, it looks great. Of course, there are some minor signs of a used car, but overall, it definitely looks fantastic. So, the petrol engines are definitely not bulletproof, but if you change the oil regularly and use only high quality fuel, then you can avoid a lot of issues. Keep in mind that mainly the 4-cylinder petrol engines can have often problem with the carbon buildup and sometimes even with the bigger oil consumption. The last issue, again with the 4-cylinder engines, can be with Wern timing chain mechanism, but I will talk about this issue a little bit later. There was only one diesel engine available in this car, and it was the 2-liter TDI 4-cylinder, which can have regular, but usually not cheap diesel engine problems. I would recommend to change the oil in the engine after 10,000 km. Almost all the petrol engines are equipped with timing chain. In 4-cylinder engines made to 2012, the timing chain itself, but mainly the timing chain tensioners, can often fail, usually around 100,000 km. This can cause a lot of damage to the engine, which is obviously not good. So, pay attention to rattling noise after cold start, which indicates the worn timing chain mechanism. The 2-liter TDI and some of the 2-liter TFSI engines are equipped with timing belt. So you should replace this timing belt and the water pump every 120,000 km. You can choose the manual 6-speed gearbox, which is reliable. Then there is the famous or infamous 6 or 7-speed S-tronic dual-clutch automatic transmission, which is basically the DSG gearbox from Volkswagen. It can have often electronic or mechanic problems, although the clutches can be worn even after 100,000 km. So check it properly before buying. This transmission should change gears very fast and smoothly without some kind of a strange noise or hesitation. You should definitely change the oil in the automatic gearbox every 60,000 km. Before buying, check the suspension parts and all the electronics. The car should ride quietly, so it shouldn't make rattling, squeaking or humming noises from the suspension. I would recommend to check for uneven tire wear too, which is often the result of the incorrect wheel alignment. Check the exterior of the car for various paint defects or rust, which can be the sign of the resprayed body. And don't forget the gaps between the body panels, they should be even on the left and on the right side too. I hope that this information are helpful enough. If you have some questions or if you have personal experience with this car, then write it into comments. Thanks for watching.